15 minutes before we start this program, we receive a volunteer call for performance by a very respected Guqin outsider master from China, happened to be here. I'm just studying her biography, and I'm impressed and amazed by what she has achieved. And we just experienced the youngest performer, I think this is the oldest one. She's 66 years older than the previous So she's a winning Zither Master many times. And I have a list of titles. I can read a few, like the director emeritus of the Research Center for Strength, Zhang Cha Martial Arts, and the chief editor of the Art of Seven String Zither, and the director of the Hong Kong International Artist Union. She also was one of the key members in 1994 of the diplomat delegation to Norway to celebrate the 40th year of Norway-China collaboration, and involving 20 concerts. Her bibliography is in the National Celebrities of Musician Masters, and many, many titles. I just can't, too many. So please, I really was amazed. And you see the Chinese are very warm-hearted and want to celebrate and you know, share the culture and the tradition and to the global guests. Thank you.
Hello everyone. Before the professor is going to start, she's going to actually explain certain parts of the instrument, the history and the culture surrounding it. She's going to be explaining in Chinese, so I'm going to have her say to her everything she needs to say in Chinese, and I'm going to help her translate after she's done with the important facts and things like that surrounding the history and culture of the instrument. So I'm going to give Professor Zhang the microphone. She's going to take over and talk about it right now in Chinese.
联合国在2003年11月7号在法国首都巴黎向世界宣布中国古琴进入世界非物质文化遗产。为什么呢？因为它是人类最早的弹拨乐器之一。在中国的远古，也就是原始社会， 有两大氏族的领袖伏羲神龙发明了古琴，当时古琴只有五根弦，后来到了周朝，文王武王各加一弦，一直到现在七根弦。那由于它古老，人们称它为古琴，在远古它叫瑶琴。 古琴呢，身长有三尺六寸五，一年365天。这13个点儿象征着一年13个月，七归是闰月，闰月。哎，那其的背后呢，有两个音箱，一个是龙池，一个是凤藻。这两个腿呢，就是大雁的足，叫雁足。 哎，中国的历代帝王将相才子佳人都会弹古琴，啊，孔夫子在春秋战国时期，他的六艺礼乐射御书数，也就是琴是为首，三千弟子必修之课是古琴。
That was a mouthful, so I'm going to try to explain if I can translate. So, in 2003 in France, they named this instrument a heritage instrument, meaning that it's one of the most important and one of the oldest instruments in the world. Its name, Guqin, actually means old instrument. So, that meaning because it's one of the oldest instruments in the world. And if you notice, like, look at the strings, it's been like that ever since it first started. And When she was playing through the sounds, there was also different sounds and the way it has to do with culture and religion and things like that. And one example of that is her heaven and earth sounds that she was making when she was playing through it. And she also explained that each of the dots on the instrument corresponds with one of the months in the Chinese calendar. And also to highlight its importance is that when Confucius was going around China to kind of spread his ideas, he also made sure that music and the usage of this instrument was also one of those important ideas and one of the most important things that you need to ensure that you keep throughout Chinese culture and Chinese tradition from the ancient times until now. So without further ado, Professor is going to take over and she's going to start performing three pieces for everyone. Enjoy.
天地人，天上的音呢就是梵音，梵音呢就是蜻蜓点齿。刚才这个叫梵音，散音呢就是空弦。 就是这个另外呢，就是二妃思顺。 是中国的罗密欧与朱丽叶梁祝化蝶，也是小提琴著名的小提琴协奏曲。
Romeo and Juliet.
也是送元二使安西，他的好朋友要走了，他是一个别离的一个很凄凉的一个情绪。
渭城朝雨浥轻尘，
客舍青青柳色新，劝君更尽一杯酒，西出阳关无故人。
Thank you. Thank you for a special performance. We really appreciate it. And this is a special gift from ICCSSA. Thank you so much.